The white balance section of the basic panel allows you to adjust the white balance or the temperature and the tint of an image. If you photograph the image in RAW, it doesn't matter what your white balance setting was in the camera or how off the color is, you should be able to bring it back to a neutral white balance. And what white balance means is that it's correcting the color so that if there is something white in the image, it would be a pure white color. That means that there's no color cast or color shifts or strange things happening in the overall scale of your image. Now, there's no perfect setting for your white balance. I just used auto white balance in camera when I photographed this, and it started out with a pretty good setting. It does need some modifications, and so there are a few different ways you can do that. You can select the dropdown and you can try a few different settings here. I tend to really only stick with as shot and auto. You can also use this little eyedropper tool and pick a neutral tone in the image. Usually that's going to be a gray. And that brought it back to a little bit of a better color. But most of the time I'm eyeballing it and I'm just going to be sliding the sliders around on my own. In this case, I'm probably going to want to move this temperature slider to the left to bring some blue back in the image and balance out that yellow. You can use those color scales to kind of guide what you think you need to do to the image when you're adjusting the white balance. For example, if it looks like there's too much yellow in the photo, then just push that temperature slider to the left to add a little bit of blue. They are opposite colors in the light spectrum. So by adding blue, you're taking away yellow. The same goes for green and magenta. If an image looks like it has too much green in it, then slide the tint slider to the right just a little bit to kind of neutralize those two colors.